para os senhores, não?
Thank you very much, Dr. Youssef. Thank you for inviting me to join this very prestigious group of distinguished guests. Dear colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the opportunity to speak to this distinguished audience. Well, as you may all, we all know that the world continues to suffer amidst the COVID-19 pandemic from protracted humanitarian crisis caused by conflicts, resource capacities, and natural disasters. The COVID-19 pandemic has brought forth additional challenges to an already faltering progress towards achieving the SDGs or the Sustainable Development Goals, especially in the Global South. Of course, the Arab region is included, of course. To be noted that the Arab Sustainable Development Report 2020 sounded the alarm that the region is not on track to achieving the SDGs. Also, the results from the 2021 SDG Progress Report for the Asia and Pacific show that the region is not on track to achieve any of the 17 SDGs by 2030. On its current track, the region may achieve less than 10% of the SDG target. The 2030 agenda implies an enormous potential for universities. Universities can have a major impact through their global activities, their partnerships, and through the education of both their national and international students. Their potential influence on economic development, poverty reduction, health, technology, and community building must be taken into account. The Association of Arab Universities, which was established in 1964, it's a not-for-profit organization established by a decree from the Arab League. We have now more than 450 universities members in the association. The association has developed its strategic plan to contribute to the Sustainable Development Goals. And I ask you all to go to our website and look at our strategic plan, which was prepared in the late 2019 and targeting 2030, taking into consideration sustainable development goals. And actually, it was built upon a questionnaire, which was presented to our universities and to other many stakeholders. Especially goals number 4, 5, 8, 9, 13, and 17. Such goals focus on inclusive and equitable quality education, gender equality, and women empowerment in education, fostering decent employment opportunities and innovation to the youth of the region, mitigating climate change, and strengthening partnerships of sustainable development. The association is continuing its strategic projects in terms of creating an Arab qualifications framework, upgrading the Arab journals through an agreement with Elsevier organization, and the Arab Factor project to assess the quality of the Arab journals, along with the quality assurance programs in higher education in order to improve the outcomes of higher education and scientific research, as well as establishing the Arab Fund for Scientific Research for mobilizing resources for scientific research projects in the Arab universities. The association is working on the investment of the Arab European Network, ARLEAN, launched by the association in early 2014 in cooperation with the European bodies as an outcome of the Tempest project entitled Leadership in Higher Education Management for training university leaders and enhancing cooperation among higher education leaders in the Middle East, North Africa, and Europe. Furthermore, the association has included a set of partnerships and cooperation agreements with many Arab and international academic parties. Such parties include Elsevier organization to help Arab magazines to meet the quality standards for inclusion in Scopus database. The Arab League Educational, Cultural and Scientific Organization, Alexo, Coursera Company for Technological and Digital Services, and the Chinese Technology Transfer Center to transfer Chinese technology to several Arab countries. Association has also, and many other actually entities. The association also has also initiated several periodical conferences, symposiums, and forums in cooperation with counterpart associations in China, Europe, Malaysia, Turkey, Germany, and Russia. In addition, ARU has also participated actively on multiple Erasmus Plus projects focused on establishing qualifications frameworks for the Arab states, institutional management, and student and staff exchange. Today, COVID-19 has not only raised the expectations we have of science, it has also shown that global challenges require global solutions. Working on the development of common research agendas, sharing objectives and joint research objects in all cycles of research on a cross-border and transnational basis will contribute to solve the complex societal challenges of the future, including the achievement of sustainable development goals. Well, let me say as well that together with the Arab League and Alexus, we will produce the first Arab ranking, university ranking, early next year, inshallah. I think international collaborations in scientific research will become the norm and not the exception. We must all face the challenges with unity to tackle not only the current pandemic, but also other unresolved crises, such as climate change, which pose existential threats to humanity and will stay with us when this outbreak subsides. Thank you very much. And I think I took less than 10 minutes, which you required me to do, Dr. Youssef. Thank you.
Your Excellency, actually,